There is nothing to fear.
First guest, introduce yourself.
Dr. Kelly Johnson.
And where are you from?
I'm from Mississippi originally, but I lived in Atlanta since 2007.
What brought you here? These are non-alcoholic. Rick, he's drinking water and I'm drinking juice. So we're good. Oh wait, cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers to new beginnings. Okay, Absolutely. Tell us about where you came from.
So I left Mississippi in 99. Right out of high school.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to get out of Mississippi because I needed a change of scenery. I grew up in the rural South.
You were on a farm?
Close to.
Oh?
Close to, yeah.
Describe it.
Yeah, so
Take us back. Sicily.
Right. Picture it. 1980. No, I'm just
kidding. Right.
But, you know, I went to school there, grew up in Mississippi. I actually worked on a farm.
Really?
Yeah.
What'd you do?
So I helped a guy like feed the cows and the chickens and all that stuff.
Oh my goodness.
Then when I was 13. And then I actually started selling his watermelons. Yeah, alongside the road, I was that watermelon guy.
Okay.
At 13.
So tell us about your fitness journey.
So,
And we're not allowed to share no pictures on here, is that right?
No, you can just share some pictures.
Your fitness pictures?
Yeah.
Not the ones that's on the like the...
We'll dig through.
Okay.
It started officially like in about a year ago. Well, 10 months ago. I had always been, you know, staying active, staying physically fit. But, you know, you kind of get old, you get sedentary a little bit, you get married.
Oh. Eric's married. I told him to keep the shit right.
So I was in Douglasville. LA Fitness, took a picture, and I looked at him, I just saw his belly.
Baby, listen.
And I was like,
where did she come from?
So what I did was I reduced sugar to less than 20 grams a day.
Ooh.
I know.
What's that, so you eat grass? Grass with pepper.
Whenever I did that, it actually helped to clear my skin up. Issues.
He is glowing. It's not no filter. This is real.
So the next thing was alcohol.
So you gave up alcohol altogether?
But not all. I had reduced it to like about 90% usage. So I do like maybe one or two drinks a week.
Okay. Whereas you were every day.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Okay.
But I'm also a runner too though.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you snatched in the fact. I'm just saying like I'm contoured down, but like this is real.
You didn't get fat overnight. You can't.
Okay, you're not gonna be snatched overnight either. Okay, that took a while too.
It's a process.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, but as black people, we have to change our relationship with food, but we also have to change our perception of food.
Break it down, doctor.
Especially when we're talking about good food. Because you always say, oh, well, that means I have to give up my good food. I'm like, that's not really good food if it's
killing the shit out, you know.
Yeah. You know, you have people that have high diabetes, high blood pressure, and a lot of it comes from sugar. It's not sodium.
So,
you know, we kind of give sodium a bad name, but I'm like, well, if you're an active person, you need a lot of sodium.
Yeah.
So if food makes you sleepy, you shouldn't eat it.
The itis is not our friend to our community.
It's not a good thing.
Then y'all gonna be in prayer lines getting healing. No, stop eating crazy. Ain't that right? I mean, I'm just saying.
You're right.
That's not the truth. We ain't gotta be cute about it.
A lot of people don't realize that a lot of people drink a lot of calories too, like sodas.
Juice. This is bad.
It's a lot of sugar in it. But
I drink it every day too. I think it's healthy because it's cranberry.
Well, I mean, if you're sick, yes.
Oh.
But yeah, if you're just regular,
This is my last glass of cranberry.
But yeah, you know, it has a lot of sugars in it, so.
I'm so bad. I'll go get some water later.